Welcome to Life Science Law channel. So in previous lecture we have already covered two lectures regarding pathologies. So and we know we have started series for pathology classes because it is very very important. They are asking compulsory in their competitive exams are like Arogya Vibhag, Microbiology and Laboratory Technicians. In last lecture we have covered hot air oven. So now we will focus on centrifugation. So this is centrifugation as we know as a biologist. So in this lecture we have to know about that. What is centrifugation? It's introduction. In introduction we can say centrifuges are designed to accelerate the sedimentation process by using centrifugal force. The two general types of centrifuge used in laboratory: a swing out head type horizontal rotor and the angle head type fixed angle rotor. A rotor is the device used to hold centrifuge cubes and tubes. RPM is only relative number which gives an idea that how much resonating force is being applied to sample to be centrifuged. Then important components of centrifuge. So in important components, this is the structure and this is the diagram for a components which is important for centrifuge. So first one is the centrifuge head, means rotor, with the tubes or cups with cushions. So what is cushion here? Rubber pad at the bottom inside the cup and tubes. Then rotor device assembly, the chamber which enclose about part, a power switch, speed control and additional parts, a chamber and a trachometer and graphite brushes. So what is principle of centrifugation? So the working centrifuge is based on centrifugal force which acts on the substance in circular motion towards the periphery. The factor which govern the speed of centrifugations are like revolution per minute, means RPM, the length of radius, means what? The radius is measured from the center of the rotation to inside bottom of the tubes, shapes and size of the particles, the viscosity and specific gravity of the fluid under centrifugation, gravitational force acting on the particles. Uses. We already know what are the uses of centrifugations, but we have to discuss here also. So these are like the centrifugation mainly used to separation of serum or plasma from the red blood cell. So in my next lecture I will try to cover serum or plasma separation also. Then the separation of sediment in urine, the separation of proteins pre-filtrate, washing of the red blood cells by normal saline. So after that we have to know about how to care and maintenance of centrifugations. So for that, place the centrifuge on firm base. It should not be kept placed near any electronic instruments. It should not run near any combustible fluid. The before centrifugation, the centrifuge tubes and the cups or tubes of the centrifuge should be properly balanced. Add equal amount of sample to be centrifuged in tubes and place facing each other. The chamber should be kept clean because some chemicals are biohazardous. Always make sure the lid is closed while centrifuge is on. Observe the normal operation noise during operation. Noise change is observed during misbalancing of tube. It could be cause cracking of tube inside the cup and tube, means holder, leaking of the content, etc. etc. The rotor will not function if graphite piece wears out completely. So in such case it is necessary to replace it all with graphite brushes. Brush the cup or tubes regularly. Place the plastic cover on the centrifuge when not in use. So it was all about centrifuge. In next lecture we will cover about autoclave. So this is all about today's class. Thank you guys.